Today I have a universal battery charger from DigiPower. It's the TCU400. It can recharge lithium-ion batteries of different shapes and sizes. It can also recharge typical NiCad and nickel metal hydride AAs and AAAs. If you have a lot of electronic devices, then this is perfect. I have a lot of batteries for different cameras, phones, and portable gaming devices, and this charger can pretty much charge them all. Of course, with every different type of battery, you're going to need a different kind of charger, right? And if you're lucky, the manufacturer will actually give you a separate battery charger. Most of them these days just give you a USB cable that you plug to the device and then you plug to a AC adapter. So not all of them will come with a charger. And in fact, most of these chargers here I had to buy, like this Sony PlayStation portable charger, this DS charger, this Canon, and this Sony charger. I had to buy these separately, and they range in price about $5 to $10, right? And it starts adding up, and then you have all these different chargers for these different types of batteries, and it can get quite, you know, cluttered. So these can actually be replaced by this DigiPower. This DigiPower will basically charge all these batteries here and more. These are just a sample of the batteries that I have. And most of them, if you look at them, they're very similar. They all have three contact points with positive and negative, and then there's a center contact point, but you don't have to worry about the center one. All you have to worry about is the positive and negative, right? So with the charger, it actually has these blades here that are adjustable, and they can adjust to any size of battery. So let's take, for example, this Nikon battery, and they will label the contact points for you, like positive and negative. And if they don't, it doesn't really matter, because the charger doesn't care if it's positive or negative. It will figure it out for you. As long as you put them on the outside, let's see if you can see that. Come on, focus. Basically, there's positive and negative on the outer contact points, are positive and negative. And the center one is usually labeled T and C, T or C, and you can just ignore that. So all you do is you take the charger, you put it in here, and then you line up the blades. Let's see if I can do it. And it's lined up, you push it in, and then clamp it down, and that's it. And then you lift this up, and then plug it to the wall. And if you did it correctly, it will blink from left to right. So I'll tell you that you have it lined up properly with these contact points. So this is with a Nikon battery, and I'll put another battery which is bigger, different shape. Again, it's the same concept. You have to line up the positive and negative. And in the case of this Nintendo DS battery, it's only got two contact points, which makes it easier. And it doesn't matter if it's positive or negative, because this charger will figure it out. But as long as you line them up and then they touch, push it up and then clamp it down like that, shouldn't fall off, and you're good to go. And then you just plug this up. So all these batteries work, including this Sony one. The Sony battery actually has slots here, so the contact points are not exposed like these batteries, but this charger can still charge it. So to do that, because these blades are thin, they'll actually fit into those slots. So again, you just line them up. This one's a little bit harder to line up, but it will line up, and then just push it together and then clamp it down, and there you go. So the blades actually went into the slots, and it will start charging. So this is a tougher battery to charge. Sony usually has these type of batteries. Their contact points are not as exposed like these ones are, but it will still do the job. So this charger will charge 3.7 volt and 7.4 volt batteries, basically one or two cell batteries. Most devices, most cameras will have batteries that are single cell like these ones. They'll say 3.7 volts. The Sony one is 7.2 volts. It will charge this as well. This is a dual cell battery. And of course, it can charge your regular AAs and AAAs. These are the slots for them here. On top of that, it also has a 1 amp USB port. So if you have devices that don't have removable batteries like these ones, you can still use the supplied cable to charge it with. Just plug it up to this port and then plug it to your device. So that comes in really handy. Like, for example, your Nexus 7, you know, it doesn't have a removable battery, so you can just use this port to charge it, or any other device like an iPod or an iPhone or something like that. It also comes with a car adapter. This is really useful for your car, obviously. When you're traveling, just plug it up here and it gets the 12 volt from your car. So a really nice travel charger because it does a whole bunch of stuff. And when I travel, I usually bring with me two cameras, like either my Sony camera and my Fuji camera. And then I also bring like my DS sometimes, or my PlayStation Portable. So, you know, the amount of chargers and batteries will start adding up, right? Like, you're basically looking at four or five different types of devices, each with different chargers, like here and here, here. And then you gotta pack all this stuff there, and then you gotta, you know, basically look for all of them in your bag, right? So it's kind of a bother. With this thing, you just bring one charger, it does everything pretty much, and you're good to go. Even comes with a little cover here to put on. And actually, this is such a good little device, I actually bought a second one. This is on sale. They normally go for like $50, and I managed to find one for $30, so I bought another one as a spare. So they're really good. Like I said, they range in price from anywhere to be $30 to $50. Even at $50, they're worth it, because it helps you get rid of all these chargers here. With this one charger, you can charge all these batteries and more. This is just a small sampling of all the batteries I have, but it can do a whole ton of them. So that's about it. I hope you enjoy the review, and I hope you find this device useful, and go pick one up.